Hello, my name is Colin McOdrum. I'm an automation welding process specialist here at ReadyArc. Today, I'm going to tell you about our new BotX XSR cobot welding system, which is available for rent, lease, or purchase. The system in front of me is the docking station. This is the foundation of all XSR system configurations. The docking station holds all vital equipment for the system to be a turnkey solution for your fabrication demands. It can be mated to a welding table or placed next to a large item to be welded. We utilize Universal Robots UR10e arm, which has a reach of 51 inches from the base of the robot to the end of the torch, to optimize our arc capabilities and deliver consistent and effective welds. We are utilizing OTC's advanced process Welbee P402L or Welbee P502L and have developed welding recipes for many common weld configurations. The driving force behind the BotX XSR is the intuitive BotX software that has been designed for use in any weld shop. The BotX software is updated quarterly at no cost to the customer. Utilizing the welding library, 3D world mapping, and quick capture elements, the XSR is quick and easy to operate. When it comes to warranties and service, ReadyArc stands by our quick to deliver results to your door as soon as possible. When a system is rented or leased, the product is warrantied during the entire duration of the contract. Ongoing virtual support is available through the ReadyArc app, and in the event of a breakdown of any BotX components, ReadyArc will quickly dispatch a technician to the customer's facility to swap out the defective item. If a customer has purchased their BotX, the UR10e has a 1-year warranty and the OTC Welbee has a 3-year warranty. In the event of an equipment failure, customers can rent replacement cobots or welding equipment to quickly get back into production. To introduce the next table size of the BotX XSR configuration, in front of me I have the 4x8 table. With this configuration, we have a larger platform for either bigger parts or to increase production. With this, we can look at it as one side for the robot to be welding and operating. The other side is for an operator to be loading and unloading parts. With this system, we can increase production and keep arc time higher with the XSR unit. The 4x8 still has the same features with the nitrided tabletops, the 5/8 holes spaced every 2 inches. Whether you have a higher demand for part production or a larger platform for your parts to sit on, the 4x8 is a solid delivery for that solution. Utilizing the OTC Welbee platforms, the XSR delivers consistent, effective weld profiles. With this machine, the XSR still has traditional DC and DC pulse weld profiles. Additionally, is the advanced weld profiles of DC wave pulse and DC low spatter mode. Wave pulse is OTC's well-known and respected arc characteristic. Referred to as wave pulse is what makes this machine stand out from the rest. Wave pulse can be used on aluminum to get the stacked weld appearance or to help fill gaps when fit up is not 100% accurate. Wave pulse is controlled through frequency and voltage offset based on a wire feed speed or amperage. Low spatter mode is available on the Welbee platform, allowing for optimal welding of thin materials or compensating for various root openings. In low spatter mode, a soft, short arc is formed to reduce production of spatter generated in the weld pool, thus reducing cleaning time and mitigating risk of excessive burn through of your weld puddle. Low spatter mode is useful on very thin sheet metals such as stainless steel or carbon, and for root passes in pipe welding to avoid blow through. The primary button on the BotX tool is free drive. Pressing free drive gives the robot to the full control of the operator. You're locking all 6 axes or unlocking all 6 axes to move the robot accordingly around your part. It's important to use the teach tip to program your points to ensure accurate positioning has been taught. This also ensures a consistent contact tip to work distance. In our linear weld segments, we'll select our weld. Once we come down, we're approached with the how-to page. So we have our approach point, our weld start, our weld path, and our exit. So we're gonna drive our robot down to a approach point. This clears us from our part. And as we press and hold that blue button on the bottom, we can actually change each position that we're gonna teach. So here our weld start is set. So we tap our blue button, It can press and hold and go into our weld path. And this can be as many points as you require. Once that point is saved, we can press and hold our blue button again and go to our exit point, which is an air motion. And from here, the robot's going to go back into its home position. Once your program's set, simply hit start. The robot will trace exactly the points that you taught it. Another function within the BotX software is the pipe weld function. Pipe welding, we're also presented with a how-to tab. So it's our approach points, our weld start, our weld path, and our exit. What's different here is our first initial point will be hit with our blue circle. This is our arc initiation. Once saved, the following points will be done with our red button. These will be evenly divided into three different locations. This way the robot's path can be easily taught around its circle. Once our three points are taught, we can also teach our exit point. And from our exit, the robot will move back home to its position.
Here we have our control buttons. First is the circular red button and our linear blue button. The circular weld in a short press creates a new circular segment, and a long press will delete the previous segment. On your linear blue button, we can create a new linear segment, or in a long press, jump to the next mode. By pressing the blue button, we teach our entire linear path. If we were to teach a next point, simply press it again. This is how our points are saved. Once a part is programmed, what we can do is select our 3D viewer and see what our tool path looks like in space. If any adjustments need to be made to any specific point, we can simply tap that position and see where it is in reference to the robot. You can also fine-tune these points with exact motions in X, Y, and Z directions to really fine-tune exactly where we need the weld to be. If we're satisfied with these positions, we can simply hit our check button. We can also select a position and say start from here. That way, it'll hide every point before that and just start at that exact position. The tack welding function is done through our weld node screen. Once we get into our tack weld, you're presented with your how-to screen, where here we're going into free drive to teach our approach point. This is saved as an air motion. Then we'll come down and select the point that we want to tack. With a quick tap of our red button, we have one point saved, and another air motion to get around our part, and then a second tack to lock the part in. As we need to exit, we can always hit the blue button again to save more points. Once satisfied, we move the robot back to our initial position and our program is ready to go. Now, simply hit the play button. The robot precisely moves to every point that you taught. At each tack position, you can control your weld settings individually or just command the time to create the tack size. When the robot moves back to its initial point, it is ready to repeat that process again. Being a collaborative robot, collision detection is a key element in its safety protocols. The BotX will stop its motion, preventing critical damage to itself, but most importantly, the operator. The operator just has to reinitialize the robot on the teach pendant to get back into welding. In terms of safety, the operator button box is most important. The emergency stop will terminate the program at any given time if needed. Next is our start button. This will start the program. From here, we have our stop button to stop the program. Lastly, our arc on and off for that added layer of arc safety. Right now, the robot is in a wait for action for the operator. So our start button on our button box is flashing. When we hit play, our light tower goes yellow, indicating that there is a weld or it's in action. So at any time, while the robot's running, we can see that the light tower is indicating we are in action. Once the robot returns to its initial point, we see that the button box flashes green again for our start, and we're ready to play again. The other status we'll see, other than green and yellow on the light tower, is red, indicating that there is an emergency or a stop.